Hey guys, name's Finn. Since the last video was a total flop-de-dop, how about we play some Cabal? Okay? Sounds great.
The unwritten times. The city grew restless, fearful, suspicious. Balance was lost, a power vacuum created, and nature abhors a vacuum. Without the keeper's guiding hand, the city was left in the grasp of thugs and tyrants, and that unlikely alliance of low villainy and high corruption, the Cabal.
Well then, the Cabal. Also, that briefing changed something slightly from the info file. In the info file, it was not the city's degenerate nobility, but the city's inbred nobility. I guess he figured, oh, well, that's going a bit far. I don't have any proof of that. Anyways, hard times came. So hard. I'm an old dog already, but even I had to learn some new tricks to make my life easier. Tricks like blackjacking, sitting people, stealing a weapon from a gaping fool, and climbing flags as ladders. However, I have to admit that the city watch, while they are patrolling the streets, are not foolish at all, and usually there's no chance to pickpocket them. Yesterday, I broke my lockpicks. As if that isn't enough, while getting out of the trap, I had to use all my equipment on some damned mansion's guards. Ah, real cutthroats. It was the final straw. I was so furious that screw-up left the job undone. To cool off a bit, I left delivery orders at a couple of backstreet shops and spent all my free cash on a lady of the night.
You are very, very bad at living.
The girl turned out to be so sweet that I spent the rest of the night and most of today with her. It's late evening already, so I came back to reality and entered my flatlet a second ago.
Okay. What do we got here? Stooge, shot caller, thief of law. You know what? I'm not very good at finding 95% of the loot, so I think I'll just call the shots, and that'll be it. What have we got here? Hey, someone was here and left me a letter. Oh, awesome. So it's going to be one of those, you don't know what the objectives are before you do a thing. Nothing but the essentials. All right, let's go. Except let's look at the map. Ooh, nice. Okay, let's go.
Okay, hopefully I'm using a sufficient version of Sneaky Upgrade here. I probably am not using the latest, but this one seems to work. So yeah, it's Thief 3, it's a weird engine, and this text is small. Awesome. Garrett, my dear teacher, may I call you that? I dared to bring you some equipment to show my gratitude for your lessons. Keyboard bump. I hope it will be useful. The range is not very diverse, but it's impossible to get any other types of arrows now. No idea why. It looks as if somebody purposely stored them up. However, let me draw your attention to the pocket lantern. It absolutely leak-proof is. I designed it myself. May I ask you to also demonstrate to us once again your special knockout method? I mean the one where you hit the victim with a vodka arrow first? A vodka arrow. And then you stun him with your blackjack. I left a few vodka arrows too. You know what? Just shooting an arrow with alcohol at somebody does not just automatically make it go down their throat and cause them to be drunk, but hey, whatever. Ex-keeper Rodney from the fraternity at Stone Market. Once again, thank you heartily for all your help. So either this is like the German style of nouns, or they actually think I'm some sort of god. Either way, it's freaking awesome. So here we go. Here's our equipment. Now there's Cabal. There's all kinds of weird shit going on, so I'm gonna have to relearn the whole engine. The vodka arrow makes your opponents drunk. Very silly. And temporarily, like, what if you shoot at the back of their head, huh? Temporarily forces them to forget any troubles. Oh, I see. Combine it with a blackjack or dagger for extra effective. Okay, explosive arrow. It's an explosive arrow. Pretty much self-explanatory. Darkness arrow. So they don't have water arrows or fire arrows because they want to get more specific or something. I don't remember the readme explain it. The darkness arrow douses fires and turns off most lights, even electrical ones. It can also blind your opponents. Freezing arrow freezes people to death. Small fires and oil lamps and candles, okay. And what is that, another darkness or something? Alright, so now I got these items now, I guess I just use them like this. And Garrett makes a throwing sound, because I guess, what can you even do about that? Nothing, because Legion was not meant to do this. Can I read this? Oh, kind of, yes. The letter says, Garrett, my dear, you are in great danger. On my way home, I overheard a short conversation, you know, between two City Watch patrols. Oh, but you probably just want to shop. The guards are going to arrest you. Run! They will be here any minute. And one thing, if you're still interested in new lockpicks, well, come to see me before 12 midnight. Yours, Marla.
Marla? Marla. Her store is in Stone Market. She complained once that things had become so bad that she had to hire a room in the shabby Doss House, the Noose and Mug Inn. At least the inn is in South Quarter, a stone's throw from my own place. Well, to have new lockpicks is good news, but let's face it, the order I left yesterday was much longer.
The order I left yesterday was much longer? What does that mean? What? Hey! Hey, don't get up on my face. I haven't read this book. Yeah, I'm gonna just read this book in my bed. You guys are good with waiting, right? Okay, excellent. Wow, there's a lot of text.
Only a half a year has passed since the story of the last glyph's activation. But life around here has changed so substantially that it feels like decades. I'm watching, looking back, and thinking, and my conclusions scare me. Artemis, am I getting too old? The war against Blackbrook is still not over, and it has lasted long enough to exhaust the citizens with taxes and drafts of 9/10 of the young men for the Baron's army. When it all began, everyone could see that our Baron, as city sovereign and warlord, would lead the army and leave the city in the care of the city council. However, no one could predict that the raw recruits would be directed to build private mansions for the council's nobles instead of training and drilling. The whole city laughed at the poor lads early on. Of course, after the flood of death notices overflowing the city, lots of potential recruits are in hiding now. Moreover, both illegal guilds helped them disappear by recruiting these young men into the guild's ranks. Both which. Is it me who is going out of my mind, or the world around me? Prices have doubled. People grumble louder and louder, because their earnings are still the same. The number of street beggars is in... Well, if the prices have doubled, somebody's earnings are doubling. The number of street beggars is increasing every day. How soon will the mutinies begin? For the most part, the City Watch guards are too busy with extortion to protect the citizens as they should. And the judicial engine is fueled solely by bribes. The citizens find more reliable protection by paying for the effective security and quick judgments offered by the criminals' guilds. These arrangements have become so commonplace that the phrase "to pay for the roof" was coined to refer to them. As a result, the goon platoons fight even more publicly for fresh turf. How close are we to finally being able to put a horizontal line in front of the H? After all this, even seeing the robes of keepers and mechanists in the city streets, which the mechanists are dead, what is this cannon-breaking nonsense, is just one more crazy detail to the picture of great chaos. As for the mechanists, I wasn't very surprised by them. Their hammer-style camouflage wasn't perfect, so I could spot them before. Yeah. Nope, but this, not cannon, sorry, nope, but they walk openly now, and this is something new. But the keepers are different. The order is already in shreds. If there are any organized groups left in hiding, they surely will be as quiet as a mouse. As for other former members, some were too old to handle such a global change and killed themselves. Others left the city and vanished into thin air. Global? It's a bit much. A few were lucky enough to find a profitable job or had prosperous relatives. Several attractive youths were taken into the trade by the local pimps. harsh. All of them bought new clothes and live as common citizens. However, I get the idea, it's a crapsacker world than ever. However, most of them became keeper acolytes straight from the streets or charity schools. They had no other place to go and no relatives to find. So they still stay together, wear old keeper's robes and sleep in ex-keeper's chambers. One reason for them to do so is that the former order's cash didn't disappear when the glyphs did, but money always runs out eventually. As I saw during my last visit, the ex-keeper's fraternity was selling furniture and robes. Another reason is safety. The peasants and bourgeoisie are so aggressive that it is rare for an ex-keeper to return from the city streets without any fresh bruises. Twice a week I bring food, clothes, and money to the keeper's library. Each time on my way there, I call myself a sentimental idiot or a foster mother, but it doesn't help me to stop. You're a mother, are you, Garrett? I had no idea. Oh, this is my apartment, so I don't... What?
The death of the Baron in several quarters and agitated against his authority. This much amounting to treason. Henceforth, all members of the sect are to be placed under arrest and kept in Pavelock until such time as punishment considered most fitting for their crimes is carried out. Anyone caught harboring or aiding their agents will be considered traitors likewise and will be dealt with most harshly.
What was with those guards in my room then? Also, holy shit! That was an amazing cinematic that could have come straight out the original game. And no jokes about how the original game cinematics were sometimes rough. That was the in-game pre-rendered looking, rendered real-time looking stuff, not the other stuff, so shut up. Anyways, what a huge fire! So close to the Keeper's Library. What fire? I must get there somehow. Of course, I should find a safe way to Stone Market first. Oh, I almost forgot! Thanks to the mark on my hand, I can see the auras of those people who are useful to me or need my help. I can accept that quest or not, but it's forbidden to kill or hurt them in any way. Take the pills, Tiger. And one more thorn in my side. I feel naked without my equipment. I should find Marla at the Noose and Mug Inn and pick up a couple of lockpicks. Good. No loading zone there? Fine. Good. Wow. Fighting all up in the street? This is very different from how I'm normally used to. New note, and possibly new everything. Really? What a huge fire, blah blah blah. Lockpicks, visit Marla, steal 65%. Do not kill or in any way hurt those people who ask for my help, but I can
Oh, I can't kill anyone else either. Okay, well, that's fine. They can go kill themselves. But how? Hang on, though, because people think you killed people in this engine. Wow. Okay, this is very much darker than the original game, so now that we're actually getting to playing here, I guess I should get to playing here instead of just reading all this. I mean, God damn. Yeah, so, my map. Okay. Marked on his map by what? Let's see what arrow replaces what. There's my dagger blackjack. Okay, the arrows don't have number keys. I gotta select them the awkward way. Fine enough. Okay, now the noose and mug in. Guessing there's gonna be a noose and a mug or something. Well, there it is. So, I am IKEA. IKEA.
Let's go down to Costco, get ourselves some lockpicks, and maybe a ceiling fan with a picture of a woman kissing the baby on the side. It's the best kind, you know?
But where am I? Okay, I came out of, I guess, what is my apartment. I don't know what the hell that is marked by. Also, this map is rather tiny. And the already tiny map is tiny enough. You couldn't have scaled that a bit or something? Wait. IKEA? McDonald's? What? IBM? Is this a joke? Why would you do such a silly, ridiculous thing in a mission supposed to be serious?
Did you think I wouldn't catch your references?
But I don't have my bearings, because where the hell am I? So I don't even really know where to go. This is a weird mission already, I'll tell you what. Okay, so this is South Quarter, yes, okay. Right, now I understand. Thinking of it in terms of the original games, I understand now. Can't move as fast as I'd like. Oh, statues, yeah. That's that statue at the ending of Thief. Hey, cool little callback there. Okay, I can't kill and I better try not to alert either just to make things less messy. Oh, I can't go in here. Yeah, the movement in this game is not fast when you're crouched, which is, you know, realisticer, I guess. So this stuff's just here for realism. Man, every Thief 3 mission ever just takes place in the, you know, regular old Thief City, except for the Valley. Well, no, that's a harsh judgment.
Why'd you give
probably
me a roundup? There's obviously nothing here, you lout.
True at all.
Again? I should have doubted
myself. Look, darn it. Really look. Because I'm telling you, something could be there.
Okay. Perhaps the Thieves Highway is the thing I should go to or something. I don't freaking know. I mean, am I just supposed to run past these guys? No, I'm supposed to be good at Thief and not have to. But I'm not very good at Thief, so... Or I'm supposed to use my arrows, you know? I should be using... Oh, crap. Okay. Now, the thing is, I remember... Oh, shit. They've got arrows, too. Crap. The thing, I remember being able to climb... Okay, it crashed. Bad sign for the future, I suppose. Okay. So, really, I just want to go up here, probably. I like that evil, demonic red sky. It's a good sky.
Better check.
Okay. No definitive... signs of me there. Everybody's hanging.
Shit,
go away. R to the wall, thank you. Okay, you just move along there, buddy. No busking with your mechanical machines producing that horrible stuff that isn't even music with your monkey. No, sir. Leave the area, cops. Okay, I should try to use my arrows. Am I leaning? Lean! Do it! Okay. It's gonna be very, I'm gonna have to reset the keys. Vodka, that makes him drunk and weird. Explosive is not what I want. Probably darkness. I'm gonna have to look these up again to remember. They don't even count as gear. You really can't replace them very good in the engine, really? Well, let's try. Let's try getting a guy drunk. Missed! So, he doesn't act amusingly drunk. And a blackjack doesn't really work very good either. That might have been the freezing it. No, there was two of them, so it was the fucker. So there's nothing over here, then. Am I able and or supposed to read these? Oh.
Center Tribune, join the hunt for keepers. Our most gracious Lord Mercier, leader of the City Council and representative of the Baron, today announced the abolition of that most mistrusted and shadowy group of spies who have terrorized the city without consequence for many decades. It is thought that many may be in hiding pretending to be normal folk, which by all accounts is part of their armory of magic. All right-thinking persons of the city are called upon to be vigilant and to report any suspicious or strange behavior to our noble city watch. A reward may be granted for information leading to arrests. Great. An arrow against all tyrants, a remonstrance of many thousand citizens, whilst the army is victorious abroad. Through the union and concurrence of the conscientious people, there breaks forth all about the city a spirit of persecution whereby private meetings are disturbed, diverse people are imprisoned, all are threatened and certain secret sects are made the scapegoats with all manner of ills and crimes attributed to them. And all manner of fears and suspicions whispered against them, our inglorious leader Lord Mercier and other in the city council fall foully upon them with slander upon slander to make them abhorrent, and so to blame them for destruction, whether by pretense of law or open violence. This much we declare is no more than a veil of smoke to shroud the venal and nefarious doings of the so-called Black Guard, who are in truth not guard, but persecutors of the people, a private army of thieves and scoundrels under the direct control of the so-called King of the Underworld, the Levelers.
I see. Why'd you guys want me to play this anyway? It's nothing but reading. Wordiest mission ever, and I mean, I don't even know where to go. Probably try to climb back onto the roofs or something, but I don't think... Looks like there's a platform up there or something, because this is all blocked off. Do I have yonder climbing gloves? Like, probably not. I think I can get back up. Like, I'm not even gonna try KOing these guys. I mean, the readme said they were tough and not easy and stuff. Crashed last time I went to this area. Just thinking, in the original game you could climb up here, sorta. But they may have removed the stuff that made it possible. No? No, I guess not. I wonder if they used this for actual required progress this time. Cause I don't know where the hell else. Probably just not paint. No. Wait a minute. Because there's nothing here. I mean, all the gates are closed and you can't keeper your way through the walls anymore. I don't get it. Well, I mean, if that tiny round thing is the fountain, then that's my house, which for some reason is marked with an eye and a shield, a lightning bolt or something, and then the noose inn is right there, but... Yeah. Oh. This is one door that actually works, but it just kind of takes me out to the same place. I wonder, is this a place now? Oh. It is, even though it didn't look like it. I see, so is this a friendly place or not? You'd think it wouldn't be, because there's pictures of me all over the place that might tip me off, but these guys are less sensitive or something. Right. So this should be this place, I guess. Looks fairly regal and creepy. Wow, this fancy dining. Yeah, a thief can't really sneak around in here very well. Maybe he wants me to use my equipment and not be very sneak-like. I mean, like, maybe that's why I'm given all this weird crap. Seriously, these doors, you just walk into the doors, why don't they highlight? So unintuitive, but maybe the engine just, I mean, I don't know, like, Thief 3 is a pretty limited in some ways compared to the old engines, in certain ways. So, it's possible that you just can't, if you want to do things your own way, it's possible that you gotta do them a little wackily. I don't know. Maybe you can't have objects that frob and teleport you. It doesn't seem right, though. So if that's that, then there should be... I should be able to get into the door on top of this little balcony there. Should have reread the readme file in order to get myself up to date on this sort of stuff. Yeah, this is almost certainly something, right? Yeah. Alright. But I still have to sneak around. Okay, I mean, I'm trying to sneak around and not use my equipment that the guy so generously provided. Probably wants to force it on me. I don't know, man. Creative stuff is good, but it's kind of confusing.
Hello?
Hello? Yeah, wanted posters everywhere. How rude. I mean, seriously, I saved the frickin' world, you guys, but you're never gonna know that, are you?
Forget it.
Frickin' glyph unappreciators. Political chaos. Okay, Marla. How the hell? What, these guys don't care? Weird. Okay, gotta go to the inn part, and there's something sparkling over... Shit.
Oh, I saw something just for a second.
Something sparkling blackly over on top of that shelf there, yeah. Alright. Oh, shit. For fuck's sake. Oh my god, get out of the way! Jesus! Stop blocking everything, cocks. Okay. Good. Now, what is this? Looks like a mystery puzzle item or something. Piece of ham? Bag of Flintstones. Near enough. Okay. This, what is this? What am I getting from that? It went bloom, but I didn't... Probably supposed to put something in there? Also, did that thing just... swing around over there into this anti-gravity thing to stop it from being anti-gravity? No, it just kind of popped into existence. Right, well, I kind of wanted to get to Marla's room here, but I may have to leave it because... kind of running out of time. Aye, you cockney guy who's completely convincing? Oh, hey, it's a helpful person who doesn't look female, so what the deal? Unless Marla had a sex change, hey, it's possible. Oh, next time. Bye for now.